Okay, we are back. Sorry about that, but my internet yet again had like a complete shutdown and connection went down, including Wi-Fi. So yeah, I had to wait it out until it reconnected with the ISP there. But unfortunate because it was in the middle of a cutscene. But I just minimized the game so we can watch the rest of the cutscene now.
Guys, they're like family, but oh God, it's going to exhaust me.
How was that?
These guys, they're always going on about how rich they are. Look, the money here, the money there. You know what they are, Luis? I'll level with you. They're very, what's the word? Tacky. No taste. I mean, I love those guys, but seriously, come on.
Okay, well, I guess I'll see you later then.
No. Hey, you're coming with me, baby. You need to hang around. You gotta act like we're friends. Shit, we are friends, baby. Make out that we got shit going down. Going down, my niggas. Anyway, let's go. Let's bounce, baby. When I say bounce, I don't mean bouncing literally. I just mean...
I know what it means, Yusuf.
It's a term from the street, meaning you have to walk. But if you don't get that, it's a bit like rolling. You have to roll with me. You're not like a fat man rolling. It means
actually
just walk.
Can we just go? Why don't you just walk?
Thanks for the explanation.
We got some meat, man.
It's kind of funny how everything he has is like a goat, his phone, his car, even the city plan of Liberty City.
With exploding shells.
Thanks, bro. Let's hope I don't have to use it.
Excuse me a moment, please. I have to call Ahmed. Make sure it's all cool and safe and that. Yo, Ada, what's up? Tell those bitches at Rotterdam, theirs ain't gonna be the tallest tower for long. Yusuf's in town, baby, and your shit about to be inadequate. Yeah, shit, I'm coming, man. Chill the F out. Why are you so head up a pump? Papa ain't in town, is he? Oh, thank goodness. It's not Papa. I can't think why you are so agitated. Calm down, will you? I'll see you in a moment. I don't have a good feeling about this. Ahmed is not himself. Very fucking weird. Do you mind going up to the observation deck and checking it out?
Thank you, brother. What? Are you serious?
All right, man, I'll check it out.
Shit, a brick. What was that?
Did you see that? Oof. My mate Yusuf and the other guy just ran over me, almost killing me. I'm literally almost dead now, which means one hit and I die. What the fuck? Okay, I really need to go to Burger Shot now or something.
Hey, baby! Bend over, let me see that ass!
Ah! Dímelo, fam. I don't want to trouble you, but I need a turismo. You think maybe you could bring one?
Sure thing, El. It's gonna be good to get away from Armando. He gets kind of clingy.
Let's get a car here. So we don't see any conflict, and then we're just gonna drive back this road, because I just saw Burger Shot's, we drove past.
I got what you're looking for, bro. Here I am.
You're the best, H. Believe that.
You've been summoned, and I know that you, your animals, even women, are the essence that continues to flow after the death of a body. Process ensure that in 1,000 years you'll
so apparently going away held some mission. Wow. That's some bullshit.
You can too. Preserve your
I'm still gonna go and get a burger real quick because I need the health here.
Hi darling.
Mala mia.
Head over to Rotterdam Tower!
Okay, never mind. I actually got my health back here. That's fair then.
In 400 yards.
I have a special gift, Luis. An auto shotgun with explosive shells.
If this don't come in handy now, it might later. Thanks, bro.
Excuse me a moment, please. I have to call Ahmed. Make sure it's all cool and safe and that. Arab nigga, what's up? What are you looking at, bitch? You're looking at a city about to belong to us, motherfucker! We're gonna buy that piece of shit dirt hole, Middle Park.
turn it into a champagne swimming pool! For real, biatch! Ahmed, what's up, man? Why the stress? You sound perturbed! I haven't heard this voice since they shot that poor polo pony of yours at school! Okay, man, if you say you're cool, you're cool. We'll be there in a moment.
I appreciate this, Luis! Hit me up when you're sure shit with them boys is cool! So long!
Okay, bro. I'll head on up there for you.
Oh, hold on. It's actually down here, apparently. Jesus. Look at this drop fall. Falling down there wouldn't be recommended.
Ahmed!
Lewis, my man! Where's Yusuf?
What's going on, bro?
What do you mean, what's going on? Chill, homeboy! Look at the real estate! Enjoy!
Yusuf! You said he'd be here!
Yo, what's wrong with you, man? Yo, what's going on?
He fucking knows we're in the shit!
What do I know?
I told you to chill, man! Shit!
Tell me what I just walked into!
Shit!
Tell me!
Please, what are you doing? I'm sorry!
Oh, shit. Fuck you!
No!
Man, this town is full of degenerates.
Jesus Christ. Oh boy. Oh, what the fuck? Jesus, how much damage did I just take from that? What the fuck? Gotta be super careful now. I mean, that's a powerful weapon at least. I'm almost dead.
Get out of here,
not good. That's some armor, actually. Jesus, that game. Like in the middle of a cutscene and I can't move. Meanwhile, I'm getting shot at.
What the fuck, bro?
Fuck, he's still alive.
Yo, it's a long, long way down.
Ahmed, get back here! Stay away from me! Stay away from me!
Yo, Ahmed, come on now!
What did Yusuf show?
Jesus. This is really high up. That would be a massive viewpoint right there.
Look! Here! I have a parachute! Take it! We were hoping to get Yusuf and Wiretap! They don't know shit about you, believe me!
Snitching motherfucker! I didn't do nothing to you!
So when Ebon uses L to move, in 5 or press A to activate parachute. Okay then. Guess we have to do this. Jesus Christ. This wouldn't be an ideal place for somebody who's afraid of heights. Kinda cool, the inclusion here of parachutes. There's police on my ass for, so I really gotta get far away here. Okay, we're good. Yeah, that was intense, but kinda cool mission.
Tahir did, and Ahmed soon after him.
Oh, whatever do you mean?
Dude took a dive down to sea level, bro. Motherfucker set you up with a noose so they could take your business.
I cannot believe it! They were brothers to me! I would have brought them anything they wanted!
Sometimes, bro, money ain't enough.
I have a deep sadness in me, Luis. Will you join me, please? For an orgy of champagne, cocaine, women, watermelons, and whatever else this city may have to offer! We must forget them!
You're gonna have to do the forgetting by yourself, man. I got a lot of other business to deal with. I'll see you around, man, okay?
Okay. I need definitely some food here because I'm really running low on health again. But yeah, I guess we could just call maybe Enrique to get another car, and then we can go ahead and hang out, get something to eat here.
Oh yeah, Montro, I'm in a tight spot. You mind cruising by in your pickup?
I can't do that right now. Armando got me looking after some stuff for him. I don't want him to get angry again.
Okay, fair enough. Guess I got a steel car then. Not close to a police vault. Yo, oh, I got hold of some parachutes. You need one of them or any other hardware? Call me and I come by in the van later. Yeah, that's gonna be helpful, I guess. Let's actually call him.
Mira, bro. I need something that's gonna help me win a fight. Can you come by in your van?
Okay, bro. I'm coming.
Okay, so gotta meet him over here. Jeez, it's actually crazy how many base jumping activities there are around the city. Probably check out a couple of them, but definitely not all of them will. Couldn't even do anything against that. Also, tree still stunned, and since I was so low on health, like one hit was enough to kill me essentially. Big rip there. PSV. No, it's not available anymore. God damn it. Okay, maybe I can call Enrique now to get me a car.
Enrique, Que la que monstruo? I could really use a turismo if you could get one.
Hell, nice to talk to you, but I can't help out.
Can never mind. Sorry guys, give me just one sec. Okay, I'm back. So let's have a look here. Where do we want to go? I do want to meet definitely Armando, if that's still possible. For the gunman.
Oh, Armando, I need some hardware. You available?
Much as I want to help a friend in need, there's other things that need my attention. Might be some room in the calendar later on if you're still in need.
I just caught him, so I guess it makes sense that it's not available right now. That's right, fool. Let's go ahead and go to a weapon store ourselves and just buy everything there. Okay, grenades are 1,000 apiece here. Yeah. Don't really need it because you already have other explosives here, and definitely enough of them too. So some armor will do. Okay, what shall we do next? Currently we have missions for Mori, for Tony, and for Yusuf here. I think I'm just gonna head to Tony because it's close by and I haven't done a mission for him in a while.
Turn left.
Turn right.
Turn left.
Now, nobody will molest them but me.
You have arrived.
Shows your child's exact location at any time.
Watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Whoa, here she comes. She's a man-eater. Whoa, here she comes. Watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Whoa, here she comes. She's a man-eater.
What's your problem, man?
Where's Tony?
Where's Tony? What's wrong with... Hi, Evan, you're looking cut. Hi, Evan, like a drink? Hi, Evan, if I wasn't straight, I'd ravage you right now.
Evan, where's Tony? He sent me to him here.
Who cares about fucking Tony? The man's a neurotic. He's back on drugs, he's looking old, he refuses to get any work done, and P.S., the man's a wreck.
Then break up with him for the last time and fuck off out of all of our lives, please.
Wow, somebody's got his sister's underwear on by mistake.
Ay, Dios mío. Evan, look, I always thought that even for a coke push and steroid junkie, you were a particular asshole. Okay, I'm just gonna admit that. Now, would you shut the fuck up before I shut you up? Now, where's Tony?
He's in the bedroom.
Hey, Tony, get up.
Piss off.
Come on, get up, man. Let's go.
Piss off. I want to die.
Okay, man, if that's how you want it.
Yeah.
Come on.
Let's go.
Come on. Let's go. Better?
Oh, great.
Come on, Poppy. Let's go. This way. This way.
What?
Come on.
Come on, fuck this.
So we have something to take care of. I ain't having you screw up.
I should have let your parole officer put you back in prison all those years ago.
You're a degenerate.
What about me? You guys can't just leave me here.
Yeah, good point. Now fuck off, Evan. You gave him the pills. Be gone before I get back. Let's go, Poppy. Come on, you got it. Let's go.
I'm good. Fucking Adderall!
Wait.
What?
I forgot something.
Forgot what?
The explosives.
Explosives? Yo, what's wrong with you, man? You want a nightclub, not a terrorist cell.
Ow, Rocco's gone nuts. He's gonna burn the clubs down for insurance. He's gonna fucking kill us.
Yeah, he's gone crazy, and you're running around with some bombs, okay? What kind of drugs do you want? I hope they're strong.
I told him I'd take care of his union problems for him. It's the only way out. Either that or they kill me.
Yeah, I wish you'd talk to me about this first, man, okay? Blowing shit up ain't exactly your side of the business, okay? It's not your forte.
What do you care about the business? You got your fucking head in the clouds, huh? You think you're a big shot. You're a nothing, and soon you're gonna be a dead nothing.
Yeah, no doubt, boss. Now where are you going?
Think I got a guy digging up Frankfurt Avenue for Liberty Electric.
Okay, what else?
The transport workers guy is driving an out-of-service subway train through North Holland. I meant to take the whole thing out.
A subway train? Jesus Christ, please tell me that's it.
The head of the LTA is out of Francis International in his private jet.
And you'll probably blow yourself up as soon as you walk out the door. You ain't doing this.
I got to. It's the only way you can survive. Get out of my way.
I'm sorry. As much as I'd like to right now, I'm not letting you kill yourself.
Try and stop me, huh?
Okay.
Go!
Shit, Tony. You're a real piece of fucking work. You know that?
Try and stop me. 1 second later, he's knocked out. Classic.
Initial reports had suggested the explosions happened during a bungled attempt to entrap
have subsequently been denied.
Okay, we can use sticky bombs here to throw them onto the crane. Seems safe. Next target is an out-of-service subway train. Hey, the cabin, welcome in. Thank you for dropping by and for saying hello. I hope you have a good day at work today. And yeah, no worries whatsoever. Definitely hope it's going good for. To get there. Scheiße. I'll offer a random German tourist here in Liberty City. What is this taxi driver doing here? We got another hour here before the plane leaves. Ava Harbinger, welcome in. Hope you're having a good day. Yeah. Yeah, the complete internet outage again. Kind of dealing with some internet issues currently, it seems.
You have arrived.
Oh. Never mind. It's going in here.
Where's this hotshot at? You got a nice plane.
Did you do it? Oh no, don't go into me. Why is it going into me? Jesus. Of course, I had to go directly into me. What the fuck? What are the chances? I need to get out of here. Yeah, it's only scratch. What the fuck? It's fine. I think we're good. Oh, apart from our car, I guess.
This explosive bullshit, or are you gonna insist on blowing yourself up?
I got us into this mess.
Exactly, man.
Thank you, partner. You should know that Evans walked out on me. We're over.
Yeah, I heard that before, T. If it's real this time, it's a good thing. He's dragging you down, man. He's a fucking parasite. You need to concentrate on getting your own life together. See you soon.
I like how the car looked like it couldn't be more destroyed, and then just random car drives by knocking off a door. Amazing. I think we're gonna go to Mori next year. It's kind of a way here. Yeah, how's Black Flag going, Harbinger? Did you play more of a game? brakes on this car wall. Hold for now, you just acquired the Jackdaw and the PTSD of a huge open world kicked in, thanks to AC Odyssey and Valhalla. It's definitely fair, dude. Yeah, it's actually crazy how big Black Flag's map is, you know. I think it's pretty much exactly the same size as Origins map. Only that, of course, you have like lots more land mass in Origins. I think I remember the team saying something like they took Black Flag's map size and wanted to make it like a huge landmass, essentially. Instead of just water with a few islands.
Hey, Lou, come on in. Hang on one second. Checkmate. See ya! Little thicko never went to college. I never got into an Ivy League school. I got into two! Yeah! Come on, let's get out of here.
What a plot twist. Never got into Ivy League school, he got into two.
Come on, hit it!
Calculating route.
So, I got a proposition for you, Louie.
It's Louise, bro.
It'll be little Louise if I want it to be. You still owe me money, so you're still my bitch.
Man, Tony, you owe me, bro. Making me hang out with this jackass.
Now listen to me, I got a wager.
I ain't having no monster measuring contest, bro. I keep telling you I ain't into that creepy shit.
No! My jackhammer would crush the shit out of you, bitch! No. I'm talking a fair bet. Calculated risk.
What's on the line, then? You terrifyingly insecure midget?
Well, how about everything Tony owes me? And I promise to get out of your life if you win.
Yeah, that sounds too good to be true, bro. What happens if I lose?
I get everything. You're rolling with me full-time, hombre. Buddies for life.
All or nothing, eh? Heavenly peace or a lifetime of being tortured by some hellish imp? Shit is tough.
Calculated risk. What are you gonna do?
Okay, so what are we betting on?
It's a race, you fucking pussy. All around the city, only for serious high roller cats. Choppers, boats, cars, and everything in between.
So all I gotta do is win that, and you out of our lives?
In theory, yes. But that ain't gonna happen, dog. Cause I never lost at nothing in my old life. Maybe that's because I had a brother as pathetic as little B. Or maybe it is because I am the S-H-I-T, bitch.
Yeah, you shit, all right.
Now, if you do win, which you won't, you just gotta help me with one more thing. And then all your contractual obligations are released.
Yeah, here's to that.
Harbinger, maybe a shorter, more linear game would be better then, if you kind of have like PTSD from open world games. Or maybe like a different type of game altogether.
Luis, you're gonna get your ass handed to you, you bitch!
Yo, them little legs of yours, they're gonna carry you too fast!
Midget.
Why wouldn't I be ready?
3, 2, 1, go!
I think I used it a bit too early there.
Stay away from me! Back off of me! Let me win! Come on! Kiss my orange ass! Oh, you're the shit!
Let's take this one. That was pretty smooth, actually. The transition here. I got Sharbinger. I mean, that's understandable. I'm guessing similar with a lot of open world games, but sometimes, you know, it can kind of like feel a bit daunting to play yet another one. Given how much time you can spend just exploring and finding out like lore, and I guess especially if you have like a completionist nature, which I guess you seem to have, can be even more daunting sometimes. Never was much of a completionist before I started streaming, to be honest. But yeah, ever since I kind of like started streaming, I did like much more in-depth runs with a lot of the games that I play. Yeah, I mean, that's true, I guess. Completionists would affect not only open world games, but games in general, I guess. Consider another Odyssey playthrough. Would that also be like a 100% run, or just like a casual one? You never do casual runs. Fair enough. Yeah, I mean, that would definitely be an undertaking. I think I'd rather 100% Black Flag than Odyssey. You know, Black Flag you can 100% in like 30 to 40 hours, I guess. Odyssey can add like 3 to 4 times that amount on top. I guess if Odyssey, there's like more of an incentive to 100% given the RPG mechanics and stuff. It's like more of a long-term motivation for like late game builds and stuff. Take this one. Kinda cool race, you know, having like obvious different vehicles and stuff. I like it. I even have Nitro? Holy shit. It's kinda cool. Can I have this car forever, please? But the noise, you even if you have one unexplored landmark on the whole map. Yeah, I mean, that's fair, I guess, you know. Especially if you already started like with a completionist run, and then anything that's kind of like left would be source side, I guess.
Ouch, man. That's gotta be an expensive race for you.
Bullshit, man. Someone must have sabotaged me or something. No, shit, no, I wanted to lose. You think ponies cash mean shit to me? I got other investments.
Yeah, good for you, Tiny. So, do we gotta see each other again?
I told you, Louie. One more job. I got some cars to procure, and you're gonna help me. Come by Brucey's and we'll hit it.
Yeah, all right, bro. I gave my word.
It kind of reminds me of a Fast and Furious, you know, the way they're just in the cars talking to each other, even though they're not calling each other or something. I'm just gonna assume that, you know, they did in fact have like a call going. And I wish I could use the nitro outside the racer too. There's definitely a car I wanna save at the house here, I think. Let's go there and just place it there so it's gonna be safe forever. Or at least until we place another car there. Am I playing Liberation after AC3 like rotted? Not this year. Usually I would be playing Liberation and then Black Flag and Rogue. But this year I'm just going to be playing games that have been mainly developed by Ubisoft Montreal. So Liberation technically I could have included because it's actually a half and half production. It's half Montreal and half Sofia. Which also is a studio that ended up developing Rogue and also The Curse of the Pharaohs and Dawn of Ragnarok. But they definitely had more of a say over Liberation, I guess, and how the writing was and all that. So I'm not going to consider it like a full-on Moncho production, which means this year I'm going to be skipping it. So for me, the next game will be Black Flag after AC3. And then I'm going to be playing Watch Dogs 1, actually. Since I'm also including the Watch Dogs games developed by Montreal. Then it's off to Unity, Watch Dogs 2, and then Origins. And depending how much time I have left in the year and how much motivation, I might also make a start on Valhalla. But that's still a big if and quite open. I didn't achieve all objectives in that mission. You would have reloaded the save and tried for hours. Yeah, thankfully I don't have a desire, naturally. Because, yeah, it would definitely take me ages, you know, to get all of these objectives done here. I would only be doing that if I actually decide to do like a challenge run, I guess. Otherwise, I have no desire to, do those kind of objectives. Okay, so this should be safe now, I hope. So it's currently 11 PM, which means I could actually take on some club management activities. Since it's opening hours for the club. Let's call Enrique and see if he can deliver us a Turismo here.
Enrique. Que la que monstro. I could really use a Turismo if you could get one.
Damn, El. I wish I could get out that shit, but...
Okay, never mind. I wonder if that has to do with, like, the like meter. That's, they're not doing anything for me right now. Let's see. Okay, Enrique like is 55% and respect 50. Yeah, I guess I could do more with them to kind of, like, raise my, like meter for them. Enough. Okay then. Let's get another car here. Yes.
bastard! Move that piece of shit!
Kevin, let's have a look how we can help out the club here. I might have missed the door there. Is drinking actually refill health? It doesn't. Hey Vimesh, welcome in. Am I planning to play Lost in Damned 2? I did that already, yeah. It was actually the first DLC I played for my GTA 4 playthrough. But you can see that in my YouTube archive actually. Hold up, let me see if my YouTube command actually works. Yeah, if you have a look at my about section, you're gonna see the YouTube archive. And there you can find a playlist for Lost and Damned as well, if you wanna have a look for that. But yeah, I played that about a month back or so. Definitely enjoyed my replay. It's quite different, you know. What I like about it is the whole, like, gang mechanics. Now you can, like, call in your mates to kind of, like, help you out during missions and stuff. Definitely feels different.
You really work out, don't you? Is it to compensate for things? Have fun out there, soldier.
Okay, it works. Does every CSC bring back so many nostalgic memories? I bet. I didn't actually play the games back when they released. I played them for the first time about 3 years back or so, but immediately fell in love with it. And I definitely have some kind of nostalgia still, because it's kind of like the certain, like, art style, for example, they have, right? For example, the colors and stuff being, like, a bit more grayed out, I guess, overall. And the whole, like, aesthetic reminds me also of games like AC2, actually, in a way, with the color scheme they use there. But yeah. I love the characters so much in this universe, especially in the GTA 4 storyline.
I think there's something going on.
Gotta check for trouble here.
People seem happy, Jay. Things are cool.
Never mind.
Hey,
is actually crazy how advanced these games were for the time, you know. Especially looking at like Rector physics and stuff. Yeah, that's a pretty drunk guy.
There's some kind of ruckus in the hall, Al. Could you check it out?
Okay, done.
Very elegant.
I hate when people try to scan the waist out.
I'll be watching.
E questo club non entri. Non è che vieni qui e entri.
Fantastic.
The Anakin, welcome in.
Lewis, I need you to take time off of this management stuff. We got an emergency at Hercules.
What is it, bro? Can't Troy handle this?
That rapper Clay P.G. Jackson been pinned down by paparazzi. Seems the pain giver needs a bad extraction.
Damn, poor bastard. I'll see what I can do.
Questo mix dal vivo, dal nightclub capitale del mondo. Ciao a tutti.
I shipped you MacBook? Oh, very nice. That's awesome. Did you get like one of the newer ones? Also like Oda refurbished or something?
My fucking car!
Are you kidding?
I like how Lewis crashes, or I guess I crash into the enemy car, and he's like, my fucking car, what did you do? After 8 huge years, a new computer, brand new, nice. I reckon that's gonna definitely assist you for a long time then. Hopefully for at least another couple of years. Oh, very nice. Yeah, that sounds solid. Definitely good to get an SSD these days, you know. Like, ever since I switched an SSD myself, I wouldn't want to switch back, to be honest. Like, loading times and stuff. So, so much better. Also for games.
This thing ain't happening, dude. We ran into an issue.
I hope it's nothing serious, boss. You take care.
Okay. Got the pictures, apparently. Enough. So there's like a symbol here for a mission, but it doesn't trigger? Apparently. Yeah, there's like a female symbol here. But where is she? Never mind then, I guess we're doing a mission for Tony. Previous one is a brand called Clevo, which is slowly losing its pieces. You're thinking about getting its electric problem fixed and use it as a server? I gotcha. That's always an issue, I guess, if the pieces are like rare or not available anymore. Because oftentimes you can fix a computer pretty easily, I guess, but yeah, it gets more and more tricky if they're also like brand exclusive pieces and not like universal, I guess. Hopefully get to fix that, you know, because getting like a second system is always nice for multiple reasons.
Hey, Louise, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up, Troy? Tony inside?
No, he's not here yet. Did you talk to him?
Who?
Tony, about me.
What about you?
About me working here, man. I can't do it no more. I ain't queer, and it's doing my head in.
Bro, you work for a guy whose nickname since 1985 is Gay Tony. Why do you give a fuck?
Because I want to be married, man. You know, I want to have a nice life. I want to picket fence in Alderney. I want to raise kids, play ball, you know? And look at me.
Bro, I don't know what to tell you, man. Desi's the man at Mason. Okay? This is the job we got for you. If you don't like it, fuck off, I guess. If you do, shut the fuck up and stop being a moron.
Don't be like that, man. You know me. I'm an artist. I've got songs in me.
Hello?
Maybe if Tony could hear me sing,
yeah, thanks.
I'd be okay here.
It's me.
You're the fucking doorman, bro, not the cabaret. What's wrong with you?
You're real tense, man. And you used to be cool.
Hey, Troy! Hey, how's business? Luis, come on, let's go.
Pretty quiet.
Oh, fantastic. What is wrong with you people? Don't you know a good time when you see one? Jesus! When even the queens don't want to get wrecked, you know this city is turning into a fucking suburb! All right, Luis, get in the car. Gracie, sweetheart, in the back!
Tony, can I have a word?
No!
No.
Let's go.
Take us out of Gracie's place at Alderney, will you? It's on Babbage Drive.
Yeah, that's definitely fair, Anakin. I guess if you're like more on the developer software side, you know, then it would definitely make sense. For gaming, I'd definitely rather get a different system, I guess. Because I reckon there's also some compatibility issues with Mac and stuff. But yeah, if you're not playing games on the laptop, you know, I guess that this doesn't really matter. Also pretty good for, I guess, audio and video editing as well. Hey, Vamola, welcome in. Best character ever. Love, Tony. Hey, Crookie. Good day, mate. Good day to you as well, dude. I hope you're having a good one so far. And yeah, I really love this DLC. You know, Tony is definitely a very funny, entertaining character. And also love the protagonist, Lewis. He's definitely one of my favorites in the GTA universe, I would say. Pretty chill, laid-back character. Has high loyalties, you know. And yeah. Doesn't try some funny shit, I guess. No worries, Harbinger. You enjoy your watch. And if you get some rest, then I hope you enjoy that too. Yeah, it's crazy different, you know, having an SSD. For example, when I mean, my HDD drive was already pretty bad and slow. So when I was, for example, playing like Origins or Odyssey, you know, like the loading times were insane, like up to 2 minutes sometimes. And I switched to the SSD and it's like 15 second max, essentially. Even if you're like loading an entirely new region. And yeah, Unity as well, you know. Unity has like so many loading screens, and you also wonder, like, Unity doesn't even have like an interactive loading screen either, you know. So you would assume that loading takes less time than it did previously, but I guess the game was so demanding that even if they decided to get rid of the interactive loading screen, it still took ages. But thankfully with the SSD it's no issue either. Water so far so good. You love having both. Yeah. It was to have an HUD as well as my second drive. But
position, get it.
Yeah. Definitely good to have like a backup drive as well, you know. Hey Vigordi, welcome in. How's it going, dude?
Tone, what the fuck is it with Louis? I mean, he'll try to bang anything with a pussy, but it's Mr. Lipstick when I'm around.
I don't know. Maybe it's your charming turn of phrase or your demure, almost nun-like manner. What is up with that, Louis?
Sorry, Gracie. You ain't my type. So can you let me be a Lipstick in peace?
Having a pussy is your type, Lou. Tell me what's wrong with me.
There ain't nothing wrong with you. If you like really la guirette.
Louise, fuck you.
Hey, look, I stopped dealing with mobster brats after Danny Lupicella tried to get her daddy to cut my balls off. Call me an asshole, but that was it for me.
I know where you're coming from. The shit I got into after my night of indiscretion with Roy Seal. Oh, trying to claim I spiked his drink.
Roy sees a homo?
He ain't a very good one.
I never would have guessed it.
Yeah, well, they don't wear a label on their head.
Oh, look at this bitch behind the wheel. Tony, you're extreme queeniness is starting to rub off on the employees.
Look, Gordon, Tom, what are we doing out of Gracie's house?
We're paying a visit.
Shit, don't we got other problems right now? Come on.
Now that you mention it, there is another issue. That fucking Nevish, the celebinator.
Oh my God, I just love that guy's blog.
Well, that guy's blog don't love us.
What happened?
He's talking shit like it's going out of fashion.
So what? He thinks he's the only guy with a mouth on the fucking internet?
This is something we don't need right now. Ugh, no one comes to our summer party in the Caraways.
Chill out, bro. First of all, the summer's a long way off. And second, we shouldn't be having no party in the Caraways with our financial situation.
This guy could sink us.
Listen to him, Lou. The Celebinator is real influential.
Relax, bro. We'll send them a basket. It'll be cool.
It's fucking blackmail with these guys. We got left off a list somewhere, so it's our livelihoods at stake.
Yo, all right. I'll check him out. What's his site?
I'll send you a link. Will you drop us off and go through it now?
But that means Louise won't be able to see the inside of my place.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll definitely do it now.
Shit, Lou. Another time.
Oh, yeah, sure, babe. Some other time.
And again, that sound that broke with you every time you play Origins, it echoes in your head. Same here. Also love the different variations of High Precision Gera, you know, because there's quite a few different ones.
Watch as the griefers battle the noobs and things get aggro. You'll be LMAOing.
What are you, you going good? Also you did the thing you taught you to your mate Yannick. He was like, that was flawless. Where did you learn that? Nice. Now at the Machino Theater. You can just pretend that you took like a private German lesson or something. Wouldn't be entirely untrue. But yeah, I can teach you some more if you like, if you want to surprise Yannick further.
Thanks, Luis. Call me when you've emailed that dreadful blogger.
Go to an internet cafe. Okay. That gives us an opportunity to actually catch up on the emails as well. I've already read them in the first stream that got the recording corrupted. So I'm gonna read it again today. There were quite some interesting emails in there, especially from Lewis's siblings. Kind of like giving him more backstories. Damn, 11 emails. Okay, we got a couple emails from Marx here. Hiya. Hey Louis, I haven't heard from you. Did you lose my number? Maybe my phone was unplugged or something. It's been being weird. Listen, give me a call sometime. Would be great to hang out again. Whatever. Marx. Sorry Margaret, I've been kind of busy. You take care, Louis. Hello stranger, what's up? Or as you might say, yo, what's up? Still haven't heard much from you. I left a couple of messages. Maybe you didn't get them. Anyway, me and my and some friends are meeting up late at the club. Maybe see you there? Be good to hang out. This guy's there who wants to date me and stuff, but he's kind of annoying. Not like you. patron when you don't call back. Which is a bit rude. Seriously, I'm busy too. I've got a life. A good one. I'm hot. Anyway, see you later maybe. Whatever, Max. Look after yourself, Margaret. Lewis. I like how Lewis is just completely ignoring her. Which drives her even more insane. Because she's super desperate for his attention. No Jacob Letta sound bit, it would be fitting for his part. That's true, I guess. Yeah, I disabled a couple of AC focus ones. Are they gonna be re-enabled tomorrow, of course, for AC3? Hey Lewis, well, I'm sorry. I guess you never got to the present I sent, because if you did, and you haven't thanked me, that's just rude. I mean, seriously, listen, I don't know what's wrong with you or whatever, but come on. I mean, listen, I'm not a stalker or anything, but I thought we kind of had a connection, and in this crazy city, that means something. Do you want to die alone, Lewis? Because I think you will. Seriously, you can't treat people like this. I mean, who do you think you are? You are an asshole, and you're not really that well endowed. I faked it. Why are you doing this to me? Seriously, why? Whatever. Max. Max, I think you need to chill out. Please, can we call this quits? Jesus. Yeah, she's very desperate. Message from Lita Lopez Wilkinson. Hey, baby bro. It's me. How you doing? I miss you. Listen. I know things have been kind of hard, and I know I've been absent and hard on you. And I know Ernesto can be a prick. He always is a prick. But can you try and keep an eye on Mama? I know she can be tough, but she needs you. You're all away and not doing so much for her, and you're all she got. I know she gives you a hard time, but she only wants the best for you. I hope you're doing well and not breaking too many hearts. P.S. Don't ever get a job in the human resources. People treat you like you need to wipe their asses. Love, Lita. Aces, good to hear from you. I try with Mama. She just don't like me so much. All she does is give me a hard time. So it gets kind of hard. Anyway, hope you and the kids and the white bread man are doing well. Love, Lewis. Another message from Lita. Hey, baby bro. Got some news from the Midwest. Apparently Dad ran out on his new family too. First it was the army, then us. And now his new set of kids. He's living with a waitress or something. He's a fucking asshole. Lewis, I can't believe you still keep those photos of him up. Anyway, thought you would want to know? Don't turn out like that, okay? I know you better than that. Just saying. Aces, I figured it would happen someday. Man can't control himself. Send me some pictures of your kids and I will take them down the ones of your dad. Much love, Lewis. Also got a message from Ernesto Lopez. Lewis, I hope you're doing better than when we last spoke. Listen, I won't waste time on pleasantries. I'm sure your life as a pimp and drug pusher at nightclub man is great. But you are killing Ma. She's worried sick and quite frankly, I've had about enough. When the kids break up for school, I've got half a mind to come there and give you a piece of my mind. You're pathetic, pal. You make me sick. Your life is a joke. Get real. I'm ashamed to call you my brother. Ashamed. I pretend you don't exist. My kids think you're dead. But Ma needs better than that what you give her. So that's why I'm emailing. So sort yourself out, or you will have me to answer too. Your bro, Ernesto. What a fucking asshole. Ernesto, my dear brother, I hope being an accountant is still as much fun as ever. Man, you are so lucky, looking at columns and numbers all day. I miss you, bro, I really do. But since you left town and don't send Mama no money, I'm about all she got left. Now, I ain't perfect, but at least I actually seen my mama in the last 5 years. You call her up twice a year, then shout at me, then disappear back to suburbia. So please, go fuck yourself. I know your tighter's wife ain't giving you none. Although she tried to get it on with me. Your loving brother, Lewis. Now that's a fitting answer here. A message from Daisy. Hey sweetie. So like wow, you are a legend mate. A legend. Seriously. Fucking fab. And I mean that. The wedding is back on. I'm so excited. I will look so good in white. Maybe I send you a pic. If you're in London or Shropshire or St. Trop, give me a bell. Especially if you got any sparkle. Toodles, Daisy. Thanks, Daisy. I didn't really understand too much of that, but good luck. Your husband is one lucky guy. A message from Tony. Hey, here's that link. You've been celebinated.com. Read him in, cause I've got something planned. Thanks. Tony. Okay. Let's go back here and have a look there. TheCelebinator.com. Party for two. Tony Queen and his rent boy, Princess Luis Lopez, are at it again. Apart from being the least convincing non-couple since two men spit roasted an albino cheetah in Las Venturas, Queenie and Queenia insist on telling half a few desperate shops who bother to try to go to the now irrelevant Massenet to take a hike. Get over yourself. Hello, sweeties. No one is interested in coming in there to watch you lap dance each other anyway.
You want war, Mr. Blogger? It's on.
Hey, Mr. Celebinator, we're big fans of your side of the club, so it's kind of confusing when we read this spiteful shit. I'm sure you don't want to offend us, so give us a call and we will try to work it out. Okay. Let's have a look at the other emails too here. We have Buster Higgins. Are you looking for a babysitter? Aloha. I provide day, evening, and overnight care for children of all ages and ethnicities. I'm a mature, responsible man. No background checks required. Send address and pictures. Prepare to travel long distances for the right child. Competitive rates and excellent references. Kind regards, BH. AKA a pedophile. Let's delete that. Friends with benefits healthcare. Cheap, cheap health insurance. Now's the time. President Lawton might not want you to have access to affordable healthcare, but we do. PPOs, HMOs, deductibles. Why is it also expensive and complicated? We don't understand any of it, and if you're still reading this email, you certainly don't. We believe in making health insurance simple. For one flat fee of just $10,000, our insurance plan gives you and your family access to comprehensive healthcare for life. That's right, for life. No catches, no small print, no medical exams. Are you old, fat, illegal, or terminally ill? Have other plans turned you down? Don't worry, we approve everybody with open arms. We don't believe in discriminating against our customers. Do not miss this opportunity to invest in your future. Act now. Contact Friends with Benefits Healthcare today. Friends with Benefits Health. Yeah, that's no scam whatsoever. And a message from Sheila. True woman judge smile. The side date lucky drink door and night penis mouth. Numerical whitening formula. Dentist grade whitening ingredients include products banned in some states for super white teeth. Look confident with a celebrity smile. Woman notice teeth fall out of order now. Sheila. Amazing English, huh? The scams are real. Okay. But yeah, that's all the emails caught up with.
Most charming digital self, like one of them internet vigilantes pretending to be 12.
Thanks, El. Let's see where it goes.
Okay, what do we have here? A drug war? I mean, I guess we could do that. Do a bit of a side stuff here.
Man, this is gonna be fun.
It's time to get paid. Let's go.
momento es pa' matarte el aburrimiento.
Si ese coste es legal, otro invento es pa' matarte el aburrimiento.
Why don't we just go to the park or something? Chill the fuck out. That would be a nice thing to do, wouldn't it?
It would be if we was all rich like you downtown. But some of us are in this to put food in our baby's mouth.
Shut up, eh? You ain't got no baby.
One day I will, and I'll have saved some of this cash for her. Anyway, these cats is holding. They got a car all packed up and ready to go. All we got to do is take it.
All right then. That's what's up. Man, I hope this shit don't get too heavy.
Why? Because then you'll kill everyone again like a psycho?
I guess. That shit will kill me one of these days.
Trying to be what you ain't is killing you. You a killer, not a moron with a clipboard.
San Juan sounds on your dial. We go to all our sponsors for sticking with us. We gonna say what we do. Así lo hacemos. Como te la gana, loco.
Con nosotros no pueden.
We coming up on them, yo.
Perfect summer. But you know, finding that perfect summer is more than handing over a $100 bill out your passenger window or going to awkward speed dating.
Okay, let's go to here. That's so funny how easily you can push your friends over.
This important shipment! You fuck off!
That escalated quickly.
Get that out of my face!
I got the product, yo! Time to roll! Man, you gotta get out of this crap.
And do what?
Get a job or something.
I can't really see myself working in a burger shop. I'd rather die.
Bro, you always pull us through this shit. Until next time, bros. Down on me.
So there's 25 drug wars total. I think every couple drug wars you get like a benefit, like infinite you know, weapons of a type, I guess, at your home base. So it can be quite nice if you wanna, you know, make sure to get like the most benefits and save the most money. I mean, we already have enough money, you know, so it's unnecessary for us to do all of the drug wars. I think, however, if you do all of them, you get like a golden unique weapon at the end. So I guess for completionists, that's like a nice end reward there. But yeah, for me, that's not that important. I also want to try the space jumping opportunity over there. See what that's all about. They jump onto the moving vehicle. Okay.
Is this really how I get my kicks?
Accuracy 100%. I kind of wonder why I take so much damage from that short of impact here. But I think parachute jumps are treated different to others. So we have another Yusuf mission available. Tony and Maury. I think I'm gonna do another Yusuf mission and then I'm gonna take a break.
400 yards. Turn right.
Engineers need to naturally adapt to our ever-changing environment, and thanks to the brilliant minds at Amboys, life just got a lot better.
Live a life of luxury with a motorized scooter.
We've taken the number one cause of tiredness, stress, and boredom and removed it from your life.
That's right.
Ride no more.
With the Relax Power X from Ambulance, it's not a wheelchair. It's a motorized scooter. You'll fly by
in 100 yards. Turn left.
As to the question, are you fat because you're on a scooter? Or are you on a scooter because you're fat? Who cares?
It doesn't matter. 50 yards. Turn right.
Pride, importance, and special treatment you deserve.
Care turn left.
Relax Power X motorized scooter from Amboy. Take the weight off your feet.
Easy.
In 400 yards. Turn right.
Than shoulders. We're getting Arab money. We're getting Arab money. Ho! 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 And again, let's go.
Hey, bro.
Nigga! Yo, this is Jonelle. As Jonelle, nigga.
I think you want to moderate your use of the word, bro. It's not fucking cool, all right?
Listen, are we going to do this or what? I'm on the fucking clock, man.
Chill, baby. Get into it. Feel it. Let's go. Ho.
Yo, what's wrong with you, man?
Nothing wrong with me, homeboy. I'm going to build the biggest fucking building in this fucking town. The biggest. My name will go down in history.
Yeah, I don't doubt that, man. What'd you want?
Well, I heard from a friend that we can get some real hardware. A bit like the chopper, but better, partner. Better.
Yeah, I don't think I can handle any more of that shit, partner.
I'm talking something seriously intense. How about a motherfucking news tank? Give it up, bro. Come on. Come on!
Hey, what you need a news tank for, man? What are you, crime fighting now?
I want it. Come on, baby, you and me, doing our tank thing, just rolling like some desert storm niggas. Huh? Ooh, Chinese person. Bye-bye,
on, nigga!
You fucking ridiculous, man.
Hey, man. Money, is it money? Is it money you want? Here, here, have it. But come on, let's go get this thing! Come on! Come on, baby, get up, come on! Let's go again, to the left! And we got an Arab money! Come on, baby! We got an Arab money!
Yusuf!
Oh, Papa! What are you doing here? Welcome! Welcome, Papa! This is my business associate, Mr. Luis. Mr. Luis. Allah, he is the greatest technical advisor in the whole city. And this is his wife, Jaundice.
Careful, motherfucker!
Yes, and you know, we were just having a little creative meeting and things went a bit crazy, and I somehow lost my pants. But you know, Papa, I tell you, you're looking very well, in fact.
I knew how disgraceful you were, but I didn't realize quite how shameful you were.
Oh, Papa, things are not how they look.
Things do not look good, son.
Don't judge a book by its cover, father. That's what you taught me.
When a book is called guns, drugs, hookers, and no pants, I think I don't need to read it.
You know, these people, they mean nothing to me. In fact, they're just going. Go, get out. You, Mr. Lewis, take your wife, Mrs. Lewis. And may I say, madame, this is not a very appropriate way for a married woman to dress. I told them many times, father, this is a disrespectful way to dress. Do they listen to me? Yalla, no, never. And you, by the way, I'll text you in about 1 minute about the tank, okay?
The news tank?
Shh! Go and leave right now. Don't you dare come back without... knocking first. These people are a disgrace, Papa. But I tell you, moving swiftly on, you will be very proud of my plans I want to show you for the Imperial Amir Towers. I tell you, Papa, magisterial doesn't do justice to it.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, Yusuf is definitely something.
Yusuf?
Luis, I think I can give old Papa that slip. Meet me in Star Junction.
Really, bro?
I'm coming, Dada. Just hold on. See you soon, my friend.
Hola, Tiger.
Please make a U-turn where safe. In 400 yards, turn right.
Yeah, I think if a book is called like that, you really don't need to read it to know what it's about.
Yards. Turn left. You have arrived.
Anakin lost his 7 kilogram as of today in his 7th week of diet. Oh, very nice. That's awesome. You've been successful with your diet. Are you going for any particular kind of like a diet or program or something?
You fly, man! I'm getting cramped! They're airlifting the tank across town. Let's intercept the bitch.
Where's your father then?
Dada's meeting some bankers in the exchange. Luckily for us, this stuff is too serious for Yusuf to be invited. He thinks I'm waiting for him in the lobby.
They're Paris, man.
Ha! Tell me about it. They think they can run your life. I'm old and ugly enough to take care of myself.
Ugly? Yeah. Old? Sure. But taking care of yourself, I don't know about that, bro.
Maybe you're right. I don't have the means. only he gave me a few billion I could really call my own, then maybe I would grow up.
I feel the same way, bro.
I gotcha. It's definitely fair, I guess. Plus, you don't need to have, like, you know, a super special program or anything to be successful. Just really watching, like, your calorie intake and stuff, you know. Or movement and stuff can be definitely enough.
What is that holding the tank? I must have one!
I wish you all the best for more progress.
Just fucking buy one, okay? No stealing.
For you, Luis, perhaps!
But yeah, if you already got 7 down in 7 weeks, I'm sure you can get another 5 as well. Jesus, the building's glitching out, well. Shoot it down here, maybe? Like a bit further to the left. Okay. Quite work out. Is there like actually a way to climb over here, or do I actually have to drive around? I think I gotta drive around actually. Stop. Give me your car. Yeah, let's just drive around here. I gotcha, Anakin. Yeah, I mean, I also love kebab for sure. I could eat kebab at least once a week, I think. But yeah, cutting down to one would definitely help. I mean, it's definitely more of a healthier fast food, I guess, but it's still, you know, like lots of fat and stuff with the meat. And of course, like the sauces too and stuff. Quite a bit of carbs too with a bread, but yeah, I do love kebab. Just talking about it, I could definitely go for one right now. Are you for real? I need to find a way to flip the tank. Oh man.
Right now what we have is a war on science. The FDA is denying access to a new drug that causes super fertility. Can you imagine the beauty and joy of God?
This is just fucking perfect. This car's just blocking me as well.
Mother Nature may have told you not to have children, but Mother Nature can be overruled, just like the current administration.
Jesus.
Hi there, Linda. Yes, hi. I'm a first-time caller and a committed liberal. I say fuck the conservatives. They're all square, and we should burn them. Mr. Hunter, I hope you win this election and do something about the healthcare.
Ah, this had to happen, right? I mean, there's no way for me to get inside the tank here.
Hey, come here. I'll give you a ride.
No! No! No!
Profit.
The net result is
come on. kann.
Campaign blog, it is not hate.
And it's just ridiculous.
It's important that our children see us taking xenophobia seriously. Otherwise, who are they going to learn from?
Speaking of kids, we should take a quick break and get our next guest out here 5 days.
Another police on my ass as well. Ah, oh, seriously, game. Seriously. Really doing this to me? Can't I just replay the mission? To be honest. This is ridiculous. Let's see where the last autosave was. Yeah, that's like 15 minutes ago. No, thank you. Thinking about maybe just quitting, but I mean, it would just reload the most recent autosave, right? So. Maybe I can fail the mission automatically by going further away here? I don't know. Yeah. Okay. We could reload here. It's definitely an easier place to get inside the tank here. That's for sure.
Attack in progress on Zeus air transport. Units respond.
Luis, you got it!
Yeah, bro, but the cops are all over me.
Haha! Good thing you're in a motherfucking tank!
It's just a noose tank, bro.
Who gives a shit, player? Bring her back to the site! Just don't have an army of LCPD trailing you back when you do! Clear those shitheads off!
Hey, I'll try.
Like the tank mission from Brotherhood, only easier. Can I actually aim backwards here? Way too many cops here. Around, please. Jesus Christ. It's like trying to destabilize itself, but something's like blocking it. Okay, thank you. Maybe I take this mission being easier back, to be honest. Works here. Yeah. Never mind. Somehow another cop spotted me. Where though? It was like nobody nearby. Great, there's another one. It's just spawning in front of me as well, you know. On my way. Why am I always getting the radius set on me, even though there's no cop nearby at all? Is that like a bug or something? Because that's not how it usually works, you know. If you get outside the radius and there's like no cop nearby, the radius doesn't get put on you again. But for some reason, it is. That's annoying. Anakin lost like 17 kilograms in late 2020, early 21, but mental struggles combined with extremely busy work, it's really easy to embrace the takeout life. That's definitely understandable too, you know, like sometimes you don't feel like cooking for yourself or eating like super healthy either. So I definitely get that for sure. But yeah, that's grateful that, you know, you managed to lose some weight again and hopefully also feel better as well.
Is everyone a shitty driver? Oh,
have to destroy all the police cars or something. Okay, now it worked. Even though I was like still in the radius. I guess if I didn't notoriety, it just worked differently in the mission. Than it usually does. Kind of funny that in this tank I could drive past a cop car now and they wouldn't attack me, I don't think. Or even investigate.
Yusuf, bro. Where you at, man?
Over here, man!
Where?
Up here, motherfucker! Shit! Stand back while I pick this thing up!
Okay, man.
Thanks for everything, bro! You're a fucking diamond!
Don't mention it.
Damn. Got 90% here. But everything except for the sharpshooter. Nice. I got 20,000 for that though. I wish I could get that amount of money in the main game. Alright, but yeah, that's some pretty decent progress so far. Let's have a look. We're currently at 13 mission passed. I'm honestly not too sure how many there are in total. Let's have a quick look. So there are 26 missions total and 6 side missions, which means we're about halfway through the story at this point. Fair enough. Road League tanks aren't in demand lately. That's true, I guess. I'm clipping through the glass. Yeah, the clipping issues are real. Also, like textures popping and stuff. But yeah, guys, I'm actually gonna go and take a break now. And then when I come back, we're gonna continue with the main story. So I got a couple missions for Tony and Mori. So I'm gonna focus on that and whatever kind of like major side stuff will be unlocked too. But yeah, for now I will take a break. So I'll be back in a few. And then we shall continue with more of the story. All right. Welcome back to more of GTA 4 and the Ballad of Gay Tony DLC. Currently with 30 mission passes, as you can see, and 26 missions total, which means now we're going to be starting with the second half of the story. And looking at the map, we have a couple opportunities here. We could go to Mori. We could also go to Tony over here. And we also have another side mission. And they actually don't want to miss out on these, so let's check that again. It may be the person we have to talk to has actually spawned this time. Let's have a look, I guess.
Dímelo, fam. I don't want to trouble you, but I need a turismo. You think maybe you could bring one?
Sure thing, El. It's gonna be good to get away from Armando. He gets kind of clingy.
Here I am, El. H Bob to the rescue.
You're the best, H. Believe that.
Thanks for free damage too. She seems unstable. So Mori is actually a dude, Mola. He's the brother of Brucey from the main game. But you're definitely not wrong. He definitely is a bit unstable, I would say. But I'm sure he can wait a bit longer. Right? Maybe? Yeah, I mean, that's true. Lucy and he combined. Most unstable brothers in Liberty City, pretty much.
How are you? What are you doing here?
I was just meeting someone. A date, actually.
A Hercules? It's a gay club.
You never answered my calls.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Or my emails.
Yeah, I meant to. I'm just...
Fucking rude.
Yeah. Look, I got a lot going on.
Did you get the book I sent you?
No.
The flowers?
No, listen, Margot, you're a nice girl, and it was nice hooking up with you, but... It was over a year ago.
What's time got to do with anything?
It was a long time ago. I mean, it's time to move on.
You're pathetic. You know that? You think you're such hot shit, don't you?
No, I'm more like cold shit. But seriously, I just don't want to marry you. And no matter how many letters you send me, or chocolate bunnies, or skywriting my name, or naming stars after me, or whatever, it's nothing personal.
No, rejection never is personal. You know, my dad was right about you.
Your dad? Look, he probably was, okay? But if you'll excuse me, I gotta go.
You can't go.
But I can go.
You can't. I'm going to die. I just took 37 painkillers and 15 sleeping pills. There's the bottle. I'm going to die, and it's all your fault.
Oye, pero tú sí que eres loca.
I'll be dead soon. Either get me to the hospital or I'm dead.
Fucking idiot.
Yeah, Mola. Welcome to Liberty City.
You idiot. Shit.
There, she's the lady that wrote me all the emails that I answered earlier.
Beautiful face of yours, baby. I think I can feel my heart breaking, baby.
No, dumbass. That's just your liver failure.
Yeah, she needs some serious therapy. Imagine if she's like faking it.
The only thing going near that mouth is a tube for the stomach pump.
I'm slipping away. Hold me, Luis.
Hold on to yourself, bitch. It would be really inconvenient if you died on
me. I was real stupid, wasn't I?
Now you're starting to understand. Thank you. Get in there. You're the doctor's problem now.
Aren't you coming in? You could hold back my hair when they pump me.
I see enough bulimic bitches at the club, Margot. You're on your own.
I love you.
Jesus. There's not gonna be a follow-up mission to that. Okay, let's go to Maury. What I heard standing creepily outside of your bedroom window mission. Yeah. Yeah, she basically has admitted to stalking me as well, so it wouldn't be out of a question, I guess. She's loco. I hate driving the bridges in this game because the cars always do like the most illogical turns sometimes, or takeovers.
Baby B, name one thing you have ever been able to fuck me at. One thing, huh? I lift more weights. I fly better choppers. I have better cars. I screw better women. Hell, I screw women. My bling ain't CZ, and my paper ain't a photocopy. What's up, Lou? So again, one!
Hey, Maury, I gotta side with your brother on this one, man. I mean, you're fucking annoying. I mean, I work in nightclubs. I hang out with gangsters. I meet assholes 24 hours a day. But you take the cake, man.
Oh, geez, I'm sorry. Sorry that I'm trying to toughen up my little bro here. My little bro who I love more than life itself. And you think that you can interfere with that?
Yeah, I think maybe you're taking the tough love thing a little too far, man. I mean, I got sent to juvie when I was 17 years old for shooting a teacher who felt up my sister. They tried the tough love thing with me. It didn't fucking work too well. So maybe try a different fucking approach.
You know what? I think you might be right. Come on, baby B. Let's hug it out.
Yeah?
Let's hug it out.
Okay!
I love you. I love you. I do. I love you. It's just the truth is I'm jealous. I am. I'm jealous. Jealous that you are dating such a wonderful guy as Lou here.
It's Luis.
Whatever. I'm only kidding. Come on. Jesus, you guys are a couple of pent-up queens, I swear. Come on. Let's go have some fun, huh? You too, B. Come on. Stop sulking. Jesus, you're pathetic. I love you, but you are such a pussy. Come on. Head up to the top of Middle Park, Lou. Here, take these headsets. Excuse me if I don't trust the pair of yous to think for yourselves. Hey, Brucey, bro, it's good to hang with you. I'm really happy you're along on this ride.
Maury, bro, are you fucking with me?
Come on, little B. Then what do you take me for? It's good to have Lopez along too, right? Hey, the three amigos.
Yo, two men and a little cunt.
Ah, yeah, you hear that, Brucey? He called you a little cunt.
Yeah, I wasn't talking about him, bro.
Don't bring down the positive energy, Lopez. Me and my brother are having fun today.
Yeah, man, we are. We should do this more often, bro.
Oh, B, shit, before I forget, there's this email that I got that I thought you'd be interested in.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Oh, you see, it's this doctor. He's a fucking genius. Yeah, he says he's made this pill that is gonna sort out that penis problem you got.
Fuck off, Maury. I thought you were being cool, bro.
No, no, I am, bro. I swear it. No, this guy can extend your hose by at least 2 to 3 inches. They call me an asshole, but I'd be really psyched if my bro was bagging a 4-inch punch. How's that for cool?
Shut up, Maury.
The one thing you do got going for you is those roid ravaged beans in your sack. Yeah, anything would look big hanging next to those peanuts, right? Huh? Am I right?
Shut the fuck up, Maury!
Ah, pathetic! You see this guy, Lopez? What did I tell you?
Yeah, I don't know, bro. I tend to stop listening when you open your mouth.
Remind me again what you paid for that place in Broker, Brucey.
Huh?
Oh, and the garage, too. How much did you pay?
I don't want to talk about it.
And, what are those properties worth now?
I said I don't want to talk about it, okay?
Shit! You see? What did I tell you, Lopez? Overexposed like a stripper in Fleet Week. Only thing more useless than that little pecker of his is his portfolio. Ain't that right, Brucey?
Hey, leave him alone, Maury. You're even more annoying than usual.
He's a bit like you and Big Tone, actually.
Hey,
you guys should start a Debtors Anonymous circle jerk together. Ah, here's our guy with the cars. Hey, you chumps could learn a thing or two here.
Yeah, a bit of an asshole, isn't he?
Hey, buddy, thanks for the tip-off. Here you go.
Oh, thanks, bro.
Hey, don't go spend that all in one place, chump. All right, people. Money talks and idiots walk.
But bring down my car, man.
Have fun.
I take it.
Bro,
tiny orange turd.
It's like, let's call the cops for fun.
Come on, Lopez, we're waiting. You're coming down heavy, bro. You think you can handle a chopper, ladies? Because it's on us. I don't like this. Keep it together on this turn.
Shut up and drive, bro.
The cops are all over us, man.
Did you see little Lou here, though? He started shitting his panties when the cops showed up. Hey, check it out, Brucey. You know, I think Lou here might be even slightly bigger pussy than you.
We're done, right? I mean, we're squared. You got your cars now, so now I don't have to sit here and listen to your tiny man bullshit.
Sure, Lou. You could go. If you're as dumb as you look.
Ooh. Excuse me?
You got an opportunity here. Look at me. Watch my lips move. I can teach you things.
Come on! Think apprentice. Think intern. Minion, yeah. Think squire boy.
You, following me all around, learning to become a business mastermind. No more clubs. No more Tony Queen. You, my friend, could be free.
Maury, is this a joke, man? I mean, you're the guy that needs to learn something.
Ooh.
Shit, you're awful, bro. I mean, maybe someone can teach you the most basic human behavior. Brucey, please, do this guy a favor.
Brucey? Me?
Yeah, you're the guy in the family with some manners.
Whoa. You think that I could learn something from little B here? The marshmallow man.
More.
This pale piece of turd.
All right, cut it out, M.
This man is nothing but beyond pathetic.
That's it, boy! Cut it out! Yeah! Yeah!
Are you kidding?
Yeah! Oh, God! Oh, yeah! What the fuck, man? What the fuck are you doing? Oh, God, you know the rules!
I'm sorry, Maury. I forgot, man.
Never! Never in the face! Oh, come on! This is top work up here! You know that I got a weakened septum!
Okay. Oh, just don't tell Mom, okay? Okay?
Okay. Just, you gotta take me home.
Yeah, shit. Come on, let's go. Okay, come on. Okay.
Hey, I'll see you ladies later, okay?
Yeah, I'll see you at the club or something. Okay.
I heard something.
Jesus Christ. that was just fucking perfect. Of the ending there. And I guess that's how Brucey also got some self-confidence, finally. Because he's such a different character in the main game, you know, when you meet him as Nico. He's basically become like his brother in lots of ways, only just not as much of an asshole, essentially. Look at this. Pigeon. We can actually shoot them for kind of like a secret achievement, I guess. There's like 200, I think, in the game, actually. But given we have a cop close to us, I'd rather not. I wonder if I could punch it, though. I gotta shoot it. Yo, Lewis, I found where they store some F-620s and bullets. You need them or some other cars, call me. Enrique. Nice. Got some new cars we can order now. Let's have a look. Let's go for an F-620, I guess.
Oh yeah, H, what's up? You got that time to find me an F-620?
I'm coming right at you with that shit, L. Anything to help out a friend.
Here I am, L. H-Bob to the rescue.
Here he is. I appreciate it.
Jesus Christ, can these guys not drive? Or brake? Never mind, there was Armando. That's like the second time they both delivered to me a car and damaged it at the same time. Fair enough. Okay, I think the only mission I currently have available that's like main mission is for Tony here. So let's head over there.
That's what I told him. Hey, I'm all good, baby. How you doing, ID? Hey, Desi. Hey, what's up, man?
What's up, man? Tony in?
Yeah, he got it a while ago. Enjoy your night.
Please.
After you. Wow. ID.
Okay, good evening, my friend. How are you? See, it's me. Yes, you okay? So I'm good. Yes. Okay. Ladies, hide your titties.
What's my name, baby? What's my name? Ooh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You're late.
Sorry, man. Something came up.
No doubt.
What's going on?
I'm trying to figure a way out of this shit. I got a plan to keep that pair of chumps, Rocco and Vince, happy. Come on. I'll explain as we go.
Just a quick hello. Gentlemen, my name's Tony Prince. Hope you're enjoying yourselves.
Ray Bulgarin. Tell me, where are the women?
Well, they're everywhere. It's, that one over there is a TV starlet. That one there is a model. And that one there, I don't know, but I believe she just signed on with the Derriere campaign.
How much? The fuck I mean?
No. They're not hookers. This is not that kind of club.
Everywhere is that kind of club. You just need to know how much to pay.
Yeah, well, listen. Can I buy you a gentleman a drink? Cindy! Cindy, come here. Take care of Mr. Bulger in here. It's good to meet you. Please come back. Enjoy your night. My right-hand man, Luis, will take care of you.
Good night.
Thank you.
So, gentlemen, more drinks?
Yeah.
Yes, please. Let's go. So how's it going, gentlemen?
The faggot is your boss?
Sure.
Last made for funny times at Bonnerstein.
Hysterical, hysterical.
Where does the coke come from in this place?
I don't know about that shit, man. I just make sure people don't get killed.
How very boring. I prefer it when they do.
You should come back on a busier night then. Normally it's wall-to-wall corpses by midnight.
You, I like. Faggot, not so much.
Hey, gentlemen, thank you. Luis, we gotta go. Good night.
Gentlemen.
Jesus, Russian, richer than the church. Buy this place, end all our troubles.
Yeah, nothing like Russian gangsters to bring a sense of peace and stability to a problem.
We gotta go to Bahama Mamas.
Mama's is more Rocco style than our place. Tell me he's gonna start hanging out with all that bridge and tunnel crowd rather than us.
Don't we wish? No, sadly, he just wants you to talk to a lady in there.
Yo, T, I ain't heard of no lady for Rocco.
They just want you to hit on her. She's an old friend of yours, Monique, from the Derriere store in Suffolk.
Monique? Shit. After that thing with her roommate, I don't think that's gonna fly. What they want me hitting on girls for?
They want you to get at her boyfriend. He owns the place, but he's in Venturis now.
So I'm some fucking gigolo now? Perfect.
I never seen you complain about chasing women before.
Well, I've never been forced to chase them before.
Do what you do best, partner.
You ain't coming?
You think having a pasted old queen on your arm is some kind of aphrodisiac? Just try and forget it's a job.
The day has finally come, T. You've become my pimp, and I finally lost my self-respect. Later, bro.
Hopefully this will take some of that sweaty smell away from that club.
No way, not tonight.
Well then, let's see what we can do.
This service sucks. Where's your manager?
This place is full of assholes.
Let's get instructions here. Here, dance meet up by moving left and right stick in time to music. Instructions. When indicated, perform a hold move by holding left or right stick in one direction. Keep it held for the duration. Whoops. Accidentally press start. Fair enough. It's pretty self-explanatory, I guess.
Here we go!
is it. Here we go.
Check his head.
All right, babe.
Wish me love, Bobby. Oh, baby, take it easy on me, okay? I had a long day.
I'm gonna make you forget all about that.
I bet you.
Here we fucking go.
Hey, yo, shit. I think Serge wanted to see you outside. Serge just got the night off. Come on. Wait, hold on a minute. I'll meet you. Get the fuck out of my way. Move. You!
Oh, Vic, you were supposed to be in Ventura's.
You whore! I paid for those fucking lips, and this is how you repay me?
Hold on, I can explain.
Hold on!
Yo, that's not cool, bro.
You put your cock in my woman's mouth, and you think it's cool? Asshole.
Hey!
Tourists? This wanna be a problem.
Hey, Vaura. Welcome in. Right, what a way to start a day. That cutscene. Good thing you wasn't there for the previous cutscene as well.
Just let me out of this place!
Okay, I think it's gonna be a shootout here, so I'm gonna...
This is too easy! I
have to do it the hard way. Shoot random people. Is there like an armor kit here? I don't think so. I need a car. You thought it was about Gay Tony, who's this guy? So this is Lewis. He's actually the protagonist of the game, and Gay Tony is his boss, essentially, who's running several nightclubs in Liberty City. And which is kind of like his right-hand man, I guess. So even though the story is focused on Gay Tony, we're not playing as him.
Lewis!
You got Rocco there with you, T? Is he there?
What's got into you? Why are you so moody, Luis? You should talk to someone.
Yeah, I get moody after I'm nearly killed, Tony. And that's happening a lot right now. Fuck! Monique's boyfriend wasn't a Venturis. The whole fucking club got shot to shit!
Okay, I see why you're upset. Get some rest and we'll talk soon. You're keeping us afloat here, Luis.
Yeah, that was Tony actually just there. Okay, let's call Enrique. Maybe he can give us another car here. Let's go for a bullet this time.
Yo, man, fuck. I don't want to abuse your generosity, but I need a bullet. Like, now. That cool?
Sure thing, El. It's gonna be good to get away from Armando. He gets kind of clingy.
Yeah. Yeah, the nightclub music is actually definitely a bop. There's even like a dance mini game, which you can use to kind of like convince ladies to join you, I guess. Thanks of a car.
Here he is.
Nice parking. Can I get out of here? Thanks.
Excuse me, please.
Yeah, that was like best parking in the middle of the street, blocking the entire way and the police as well. Classic. Okay, let's head over here to Tony again, I guess. Let's also call Armando. Maybe he can give us some guns and stuff.
Oh, yeah, man. I need some armor. You available?
Fuck! Can't have you out there unarmed? I'm on my way.
Oh damn, it's actually quite less expensive here. We got 1,500 to spare. Okay, let's get the body armor for sure. Let's also get some parachutes here because we can definitely need that as well. We could get a 44. I mean, what else? Let's buy some auto shotgun rounds, I guess. Some explosive ones. Okay, there's the advanced sniper. I already have enough of these. Okay, let's get the 44 here.
I like it.
And let's also get a grenade launcher, I guess.
I can see myself rolling with one of these.
Good thing about the grenade launcher is the round's actually much less expensive than the RPG, even though we have like less of a bang, I guess. But yeah, that works. Maybe also a couple of grenades. Actually, never mind, I have another explosive here. I have these sticky bombs. So that works.
I'll see you soon, bro.
Later on, L.
Dude. Can you stop driving into me, Armando? That's like the, I don't know how many times today, probably fifth time. But he delivered something for me, just drove right into me. DLC alongside the main story? It is, yeah. Both DLCs are kind of like intertwining with the main story, and they take place pretty much at the same time. So it's like always about showing a different perspective with different characters on the same kind of like events, I guess. Oh yeah, I love this one too, Aura. It's actually my custom-made playlist for the game. Of course, you can have an independent radio station where you can basically put in your own tracks inside a folder. And then the game will play those tracks as like part of a radio station. What song is it? I could be wrong, but I think it's Alexander Yamaha or something. I think so. I can look that up for you if you want. Yeah, no worries. I can have a look into my folder here. Oh yeah, I was right. My memory didn't fail me there. Hey, the Nemesis, welcome in. Good morning. No worries, Aura.
Not even.
Oh, look who it is!
Jesus, you could nap or something. I mean, my heart is beating 200 beats a minute. You almost put me in the hospital.
This is good blow.
Here, give me some.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, Gracie, tell your father. Tell him.
Tell him you've been selling me coke. He will love that.
No. I don't mean that. I mean, tell him I'm okay. You know, tell him I'm on the up.
Yeah, tell him if he needs a good fake tan or some hair gel, Rocco can hook him up.
Oh, fuck off, Luis.
Try it, bro. I'll happily do more time for you.
Oh, Luis, you always gotta act so tough. Just have a fucking line and chill out like me. You people.
Luis is always such a buzzkill.
We're meant to be having fun here. I'm having fun. I am. Where's my fucking phone?
This coke is kind of speedy, Rock.
Where's Tony?
He went out.
You better not be spiking me with speed, Rocco. I will be so angry.
Where did he go?
Who? What is wrong with you, man? You are ruining my buzz, Luis.
Tony, where's Tony?
He is over there.
Oh, yeah, he passed out again. Guy's a fucking mess, Luis. Holding you back.
He holds everyone back.
No, he doesn't.
Get up.
No.
Come on, get up.
Get up, you has-been, no good 1980s throwback relapse junkie fan!
What's wrong with you, Tony? Get up, baby!
Oh! Ladies and gentlemen, more shots! Oh, hey! What, guys? What's going on?
You tell me, boss. What's going on?
What?
Why'd you call?
I don't know.
Because of that thing, T? Come on, that sparkly thing. Wake up, you junkie fag.
Oh, right. That thing. That shit. Right, that thing. Okay, all right, Luis. All right, we gotta go. All right, ladies, have some fun. Try to keep your septums all in one piece, huh? Oh, Jesus, man. Yeah. I feel like a camel shat in my mouth. Oh, well, at the end, it wasn't fun.
Here we go.
Oh, no. Not again. No.
Hold on, guys. I wanna come too.
Fuck off, Evan. This is work. It's not working out.
Whatever.
So anyway, Sharon, I think I'm gonna sell my car.
Oh my god, that is so funny!
Wait, what's so funny about that? Absolutely nothing!
Oh my god. Yeah, don't do drugs.
For these limos, so we're gonna take them. I'll go with the driver and try to rebuild my psyche. Luis, you take Evan.
Thanks a lot, Don.
Take us out to East Hook, Luis. Come on, chop chop.
What exactly are we doing, man?
Listen, Luis, no offense, but I don't know how much I'm allowed to tell you.
What you mean, Evan? Tell me everything you know.
Really? I mean, how much information are you privy to? You're just the fucking driver, after all.
Yeah, I'm privy enough to know that you're a piece of shit who's using Tony and you're only gonna be hanging around for 2 to 3 months before Tony moves on to another chunk. I'm privy to the fact that the coke in your nose and the roids in your veins are gonna send you worse out of control real soon. I'm also privy to the fact that you're gonna be some fat trailer park queen back in the Midwest before you hit 30. Now tell me what the fuck we doing right now!
That attitude's not gonna get you anywhere, sweetie. You better say something nice to me.
Tell me what's fucking happened.
If you say something nice, I'll think about it.
You can get Tony fucked up like no one else can, Evan. That nice enough?
Aw, sweet. Thank you, Louise. Tony is more fun when I'm around. What do you want to know?
What are we doing going to the docks in East Hook?
We're buying diamonds, $2 million worth.
Ay, Dios mío. Where did Tony get that kind of cash, bro?
You don't know everything, do you, Louise?
Yeah, I know that money can't be his unless he borrowed it. Where's it from?
How the fuck should I know? I'm the looks, not the accountant.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. You just snort the money. You don't know where it comes from.
The money could be Bracco's, it could be Gracie's. Who cares? We're getting some ice, baby.
Yeah, I don't like the sound of this, bro.
See what I mean? Always so serious. Don't worry for once. Tony skimmed 10% off the agreed amount, so we'll have some spending money. Whoop, whoop! Gonna hit the shops today, baby!
Yeah, even fucking better, bro. Even better.
Hook is the opposite of Joe. You have never once thought, you know what, would be great right now if you were more anxious. Yeah. I mean, especially if you're kind of like preconditioned to be anxious, that wouldn't be a good idea at all. It's kind of funny, you know, that these games get kind of like a lot of criticism for showcasing drugs and stuff. But honestly, I think the way they're showcasing is more like putting you off of trying to do something like this, you know. It's the same thing with Breaking Bad, you know, getting like a lot of criticism for making like drugs a central topic, I guess. But it's more like, you know, showing like the negative impacts of that kind of like consumerism and business, you know, to be honest. So.
You have arrived.
Hey, what's going on? Which one is Mr. Tony?
That would be me. All right, you got what we're looking for?
You got the money?
Sure, right here.
Then I'll get the ice. Hold on.
How you feel about this, bro?
I think I need another fucking line, okay? It serves me right for leaving the party with you losers.
Shut up, idiot. Tony, we cool?
Let's just get this over with. My head is killing me. My life has been reduced to this bullshit. So no, Luis. We are a long way from cool. But for right now, let's just see what the chef has to say for himself.
Yeah, that's what I think. I agree.
Ay, cállate, por favor.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. This is them.
These are great. They're great. But, $2 million. You had your head in the oven?
Mr. Tony, I have what I tell you. Perfect clarity. Beautiful clarity. Well cut and a shitload of carrots. What do you expect?
Tony, they're gorgeous.
Just like you.
Come on, can we do a handover, please, and get out of here? This is too much.
No, ignore him. He's probably been up all night with some bimbo.
Tony.
You're a chef.
Well, cook, yeah.
I have a line on some kitchen supplies. How about I throw that into the equation? What's the price?
Look, here's the money we agreed upon, less 10%. Just give us the ice.
All right.
Hey. Tony, can I hold them? Thank you.
Thanks.
Oh, shit, Tony, we out of here. Come on, let's go. Evan, take him to the club and don't fuck about, okay?
Because I'm not putting my fucking seatbelt on!
fucking hell. You see that? I kind of like tried to throw the bomb in advance, and now it's like right next to our car. Which means if I now press explosion, I'm gonna die, essentially. But I gotta press explosion because we're now stuck here. So I officially fucked up. Oh boy. That's not good. Gotta replay this one, I guess. Or isn't the whole plot of Breaking Bad that he sells meth to pay for his medical bills? Why aren't people mad about his medical bills? Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of how it starts, I guess, you know, that he's kind of like going into the business because he has a cancer diagnosis and he sees that as the fastest way to get money to secure the future of his family. But very quickly, you know, he starts doing it for the business because he likes doing it, I guess. Like, I guess making meth and being part of the criminal underworld. It's definitely glorifying that to some degree. But at the same time, it's also showcasing all the negative impacts, right? Because it's a super tragic and, horrible outcome story. So there's nothing positive coming out of that, you know? Not really. Remember that scene? Yeah, we have a scene both in... I mean, we only had it in Lost and Damned, I guess. But there's a very similar scene also in the main game, too. And we're dead. Had to happen, I guess. Shit. Were we? Never mind. Kind of survived. Somehow. We have two more explosives. I have no idea how we survive that, to be honest, but I take it.
A chopper too? Perfect! Must be my day! Say goodbye! Hey, boys! I don't want to die here!
Okay, I have infinite ammo apparently. Chopper. Never mind then. Jesus, I'm so low on health now. Please tell me we're done soon.
They shot him!
Fuck, bro!
What are they gonna do?
I'll take the wheel, man. Just calm down a minute.
Shit, poor Costas. We gotta lose these fucks.
Sorry, Costas, honey. We gotta get out of here.
Okay. Let's get out of here. Please survive.
We lost him, P.
Okay.
What happened to Evan?
He went the other way with those diamonds. Probably on the next plane to Los Santos, if you ask me.
He's not answering his phone. I'll check his bleeder.
He's not gonna update some social networking site when a couple of dozen irate bikers are trying to kill him, bro. No one's that vain. Not even him.
10 man 89 bleeded less than 10 minutes ago.
I can't believe it, man. What's it say?
Cornered by bikers? Ugh. Too young to die? They fucking got him!
Jesus. Poor bastard.
I know! Fuck! Poor Evan. He was a rotten human being. That's why I liked him so much.
That fuck got himself killed. And a diamond stolen, I might add, because he needed to tell the internet about his problem. Oh yeah, I can speak ill of him as much as I fucking want. That's the stupidest thing I ever heard.
All right, it was a weird move, I'll give you that. But he's dead, killed by social networking. He may have cheated on me and stolen from me and put his plastic surgery on the business credit card, but I like the guy and I'm kind of sad, okay?
Well, I didn't like him. He's dead and he's still pissing me off. We just lost 2 million on those diamonds.
Calm down, Luis. You think your boyfriend had just been killed?
Diamond money, monkey boy!
You really think Evan's dead?
I'm sure of it. He bleated, didn't he?
I'm sorry, bro.
Those diamonds are gone too, Lou. We're really in this shit now. We've got no more cards to play. What the fuck is going to go wrong next?
Stay cool, and don't get too fucked up on those pills. Or that Charlie. Or any fucking new shit. Hey, Evan ripped you off and he didn't get away with it. Look at it like that. I'll come see you soon.
Sure, whatever. So long, stranger.
Well then, that went freaking fantastic, didn't it?
Please make a U-turn where safe. In 200 yards, turn left.
Thought the helicopter was overkill, but you've got the grenade launcher. Yeah, his DLC is definitely bringing it to the next level with the amount of explosions you can produce.
In 200 yards, turn right.
Could also live tweet your demise. Yeah, who wouldn't, right? In this day and age.
In 400 yards, turn left.
Hey, bro, what's happening?
I've organized that face-to-face with our good friend, the Celebinator.
Oh, shit. We're gonna show him a good time?
Yeah, I thought we could persuade him that we're not such bad guys after all. He's meeting us at the heliport on the West River. We're taking him out on a tour of the city.
I wouldn't miss this. See you there, T.
Calculating route. Please make a U-turn where safe.
I have a feeling Evan didn't die. Yeah, maybe. I honestly don't remember if he does or not.
Turn left.
It's been a couple of years since I played this for the first time. Bit of gay Tony with pansexual flag colors.
How is it going, man? Don't shoot at me now.
Kind of like the art style that I went with in this DLC. In general, I think each DSC feels very, very unique and different in its kind of like style. Okay, so I gotta go there, but I really need to get some food as well because I'm super low on health, like one hit and I'm dead essentially. So I gotta find a place to eat. There's like lots of restaurants here, but I can't actually eat there, so I need like a burger shot or hot dog stand or something like that, you know?
Please make a U-turn.
Can't talk to anybody and hang out, can I? Yeah, I can't hang out right now. Of course, it technically has started the mission here. It's kind of annoying they don't showcase any places where I've eaten before. You know? Like, we gotta find them ourselves now.
100 yards. Turn right.
I mean, technically what I could do actually is I could go to Masonet 9 because we have like a health kit there that spawns. But I don't remember the exact location, so that's not really helping either.
Turn right.
Because since we're in a mission, it doesn't showcase that symbol either. Just gotta keep my eyes open here for any kind of like good place. Ah, there's a clacking bow. Perfect.
Cluckin' bell! What up?
Usually in a story when someone is presumed dead off scene with weak proof, it means they're not actually dead. That's true, I guess.
Hey, thanks for coming in to Cluckin' Bell!
It definitely does tend to happen. There's lots of restaurants, but you can't actually eat here. Story of a life as a neurotically picky eater. Well, at least you know what you want, right? What are these pictures here?
Hey,
That shit's gonna be on the news.
Would be cool if you get a portrait of yourself drawn. You actually don't. Fair enough, I guess.
In 200 yards, turn right. In 50 yards, turn left. In 200 yards, turn left.
Okay, so we have 4 armor and health again. That's a good starting position here for the next mission.
You have arrived.
All aboard, Lou. Here's that chute you wanted. You're really gonna get over that fear of flying.
You're confusing the shit out of me, Tony.
Let's show our friend a view of the city. Take us up above Happiness Island. Luis, meet our new friend, the Celebinator.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Yo, do you got like a real name? Or do I gotta call you the what's it?
This is a gay I wear in public. I'd prefer it if you called me the Celebinator.
Okay.
It's a lovely helicopter you've got here, Tony.
I'd love to say this was mine, but I'm just borrowing it off a rich friend of mine, Mr. Yusef Amir. He let us use it because it's such a special occasion.
This is a very grown-up gesture of yours. I thought it'd be just tit for tat from here on in.
What you mean tit for tat? You just started insulting us on your website. We ain't done shit to you.
I'm not naive, Louis. The Derriere launch, Mason, its 5th birthday, he left me off the list. It was a deliberate snub.
What you talking about, man? We never even met you.
I was on the scene, Louis. Fuck it. My Odyssey. Me. Why? Leaving me off an M list, it was a declaration of war. So I fucking brought it.
Oh, yeah, you want the looter motherfucker, man. Having a website don't make you the scene.
Not now, Lou. We're trying to charm him.
So, it's time he asked. What's it gonna take to get me off your box?
Excellent. Blackmail's a language I know only too well.
Your problem is that you think...
Show our friend the sights, El. I'll take the controls.
You really don't have to show me anything. I've vlogged every inch of this town.
You know what? I don't think you ever seen Liberty City like this.
What you doing, Tony? Help!
You pick up, you motherfucker!
Fuck, no! Fuck!
You thought you could play us, you arrogant fuck?
I'm sorry. Did I just hurt you?
He's scared, Lou?
You're a long way from the blogosphere, motherfucker!
Oh, fuck! Fuck, shit!
We got too many bloggers in this town already. Drop him!
This how we do tit for tat where I'm from.
The world ain't gonna miss a blogger!
You can't do this to me! I'm a celebrity!
I think you're slipping!
People are gonna thank us when he's gone, Lou.
You're a fucking disgrace!
To lose some pounds, bro. You're too fucking heavy.
Go get him, Luke!
Chance at life. You're a fucking miracle.
Get away from me! Get away from me!
You wanna let go? Be my guest. What's that smell, man?
Ah!
kind of looks like you had a little accident. Someone might post a picture of that online.
I feel like shit.
That's because you shit yourself, dude. perfect. And the missions are so damn funny in the Ballad of Gay Tony.
Louise, how'd you boys get on after you left me?
Okay, T. He's an annoying little fuck, but I think we saw eye to eye by the end of it. He ain't gonna be giving us no smack talk no more.
That's excellent news. We should schmooze these citizen journalists more often.
It would be my pleasure.
Citizen!
Citizens? You know, for every protagonist in these games knows how to fly a chopper. Yeah, it's just like a natural tendency to know all about all kinds of vehicles, if it's a tank or chopper. Or if I'm controlling the character, I can't really fly a chopper though. Or at least really badly.
Hello.
Commander, your club. I'm Ray Bulgarin.
Oh yeah. You're the Russian who was asking about cold cookers and corpses. Yeah, I'm sorry we couldn't accommodate.
I did not take you for the sensitive type. I'm spending some time here while I'll catch up with some old friends. And I need help with some things. I'm told you are the man to talk to.
Listen, man, I got a real busy schedule.
This is not an opportunity you want to miss out on, especially as I hear that Gay Tony Prince's ship is sinking.
Now, I don't know where you heard that.
Just come to my house. We will talk.
I don't want to talk to you. Yeah, there was a bit of a rough landing there. I like how it just like flew away completely when landing. Yeah, the reactor physics are just amazingly perfect in this game. I mean, to be fair, they're really good actually, especially for its time, but yeah, there's some funny situations where it don't work as intended.
Have you heard the news? Evan's definitely dead!
Okay, we expected this, though. Don't freak out. He was an asshole. My guess is he was intending to steal them diamonds when the bikers got him.
Okay, Evan was a conceited dick, a lowlife, a whore, a drug peddler, and a thief. He treated me like dirt. That's the kind of guy I like.
You should start going back to the shrink, bro.
Screw you. Anyway, that doesn't solve the diamond issue. Rocco's saying we owe him his share of the profits on top of everything else.
This ain't good, man. But we'll find a way out of it. You've been in worse case before. I'm counting on your leadership.
You believe those stories? Wow. I never took you for an idiot. I just pretended to know what I was doing. I'm a schmuck who got lucky. Shit, we really are screwed.
Yeah, we are. Because I have to fix everything you do. Okay, I think we're doing one more kind of like smaller side mission for today before I'm gonna call it. Set up here.
Turn left. In 100 yards, turn right. Turn left. In 800 yards.
That's it. What's up, man?
Hey, boss. I'm just wondering when you think you're gonna do a shift at the club. This place could do with that Luis Lopez magic.
I'll try to put some time in soon, man. It's just been kind of crazy. Trust me. Look after things.
I mean, maybe I could do that instead, actually. Because, yeah, the club does need my help, actually. Let's head over here. Do a club shift and then we're gonna call it.
Turn.
Mile. Turn right.
I gotta make my stations a playlist or something. I mean, I could do that. First demand. Yeah, I can definitely do that. That's no worries. Wouldn't take too long either, because I already have it as a playlist locally either way. The demand is you. Yeah, I could definitely do that aura. Might even create that later, to be honest. Hey, Varot, welcome in. How's it going, Sunny? I hope you had a good rest of the stream today with Resident Evil 4. Did you actually finish the game in your second part? Very sorry. Be sure that it's all done. Nice. That's awesome. GG's on finishing it. So that means tomorrow's gonna be another AC day then?
Body, Al. Shame about the little guy.
Try not to catch any more infections, soldier.
Watch out.
Al, can you head to the dance floor? I think there's something going on.
Great fucking tune.
You stopped and deny me now.
But hell, you have more AC, so now it will be 5 days of AC every week until the annual series is done. Nice. Yeah, you're definitely gonna be able to get through it quite quickly at that rate, I would say. Yeah, that's awesome. So what did you think about Resident Evil 4 Remake now that you finished it? Would you say it's a worthy remake? Does it kind of like hold up to the original? Yeah, it's a ground here for trouble. Seems to be good for now, actually.
I gotta kick someone out for being a douche. We cool here.
Al, stop whatever you're doing right now and come straight to the office.
Is she trying to hit on me again or something? Or if this place should play my music, you at every party or road trip when you're hogging the orcs. Yeah, I'm the same. Love playing some own playlists or something.
I got here as fast as I could. What's going on?
Nothing. It's just like... What the fuck is this, Luis? Is something going on? Is it not going on?
Huh?
Actually, don't worry. Forget I said anything. Just forget it. I should probably go on meds or something.
Okay, Joni. This is weird. Try to relax, yo. I'm going back to work now.
Yeah, she's still hitting on me. So I could quit managing here. There's something I could do there. I'm gonna stay on duty for now.
Hey Al, it might be worth heading down to the VIP. I see something weird down there.
Be there in a minute.
But you really enjoyed it. There were some frustrating parts, but that's just gameplay, usual video game kind of annoying parts. But it's a solid remake. There are some things missing from the original, but it doesn't take away from anything not having it included. It follows the story the same with some extra aspects of things. I gotcha. Definitely sounds like a good time overall. And I mean, yeah, that's fair. I mean, to be honest, every game has its kind of like rough cuts, you know, and annoying parts to get through. Even the games that I love deeply has, you know, annoying parts. So I guess that's just a given sometimes, you know. Oh, that's great. I'm glad you had a good time. Definitely sounds like it was worth the time and investment. Clooney has a weird way of hitting on people. Yeah. Yeah, they're all crazy for Lewis, it seems. They become very desperate very quickly to get his attention.
Things are closing down, Louise.
Getting this serious creepy rape vibe off some dude, man.
I wouldn't want to be them.
Asshole. Still getting your hands dirty. That's what I like to see. Keep him out, bro.
It is closing time. Your shift is over. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's like 6 in the morning. I guess the shift is getting to a close. See you later, D. Okay, let's call Enrique for a car, if he can deliver.
Enrique, it's Luis, bro. I was thinking I could really use a bullet. You know of one that might be available?
No problem, homie. Anything to get off this corner.
That's a true rod? Yeah. I mean, even AC2, you know, has like parts where I'm like, okay, yeah. It's not really my favorite mission or like objective or something, you know?
Thank you.
It's like every time I try to, call a car, a Mando came by and either crashed into the car, into me or Enrique. But Enrique got driven over like 4 times today already or something. It's crazy. Every time. But yeah, thanks for the car, though. Classic Mike Snow song, good remix. Yeah, that song always reminds me of Friday Night Dinner, the show from the UK, because it's kind of like the title track, I think. It's a bit weird hearing it in this context now, you know, of like Nightclub Life. But I do like it, for sure. Okay, let's head back to safe house. Yeah, it's definitely a different vibe altogether that he's listening to. Yeah, it's pretty old at this point, isn't it? Like maybe 2010 or something, I would reckon. He is Rod, yeah. We actually did all the use of missions today, or at least the first batch of use of missions, and it's so damn funny. Especially when his father confronts him in his apartment. We're getting A-Rep money. Also like how everything he has is like gold. You know, like his phone is golden, even his, weapons are. Even the city plan that he has of New York is golden. But yeah, he also got that Arab money, so. Actually, 14 years old. Yeah. It's crazy how long ago it is at this point, you know. Oh, whoops. I didn't actually change that. Okay, there we go. That's like his classic look. I guess when we're not on shift, I can just use this more like casual look here. And then it's time to sleep because I want to save the game here. All right. And yeah, this is going to be where we call it today for the Ballad of Gay Tony. I want to thank you all so much for coming by and for joining me for another session of this. The next one is going to be on Thursday, I think. And yeah, there might even be a chance, I guess, for us to finish it. We're currently at 17 missions done. And I think there's 26 total. So yeah, if we do like a decently length stream, I think we should probably get to the ending in the next stream here. And of course, depending how difficult they are to complete. But overall, it's a bit easier with this DLC because there's actually a checkpoint system. So if you have to replay a mission, then it's gonna not set you all the way to the start of a mission, but you're actually gonna be back to the most recent checkpoint. So if we fail, then that should be really helpful, actually. So yeah, let's go ahead and exit the game here. And this is gonna be where we will call it for today. No worries, Aura. Thank you for being here. Cheers, Rod. I hope you have a good night and rest later. Yeah, this is definitely such a good DLC. And honestly, Lewis is probably one of my absolute favorite characters in the universe. I mean, he's so different to Nico, so it's kind of like hard to compare. I guess I love both of them. But I think both Nico and Lewis are my favorites so far, at least, out of the games and DLCs that I played. I just love that Lewis has this kind of like chill energy, I guess, you know, and he's definitely more of a laid-back character, you know, that you can resonate with a bit easier. And he also doesn't shy away from, like, you know, telling how it is, I guess. He doesn't take shit from anybody, similar to how Nico doesn't. He really is laid back, and you love how he reacts to people like Brucey's brother. Yeah, we have that storyline earlier as well. It's really funny seeing Brucey the way he's been before he meets Nico, you know? Because in a way he becomes more like his brother, Mori. But at the same time he's like way less of an asshole. And speaking of him, he's actually on the right side there. There he is. Mori. I mean, Mori's funny, I guess, but he's definitely an asshole. The way he treats Brucey as well, you know. Mori the moron, that's true. It's me, Morion. But yeah, let's have a look who's online and who we could raid today. Say hi to Ronnie today. He's actually playing some Marvel Spider-Man Miles Morales, a game that I really love a lot. And I think he's getting quite close to finishing off the game, at least from what I remember. So yeah, let's have a look over there, see how he's doing. Also quite fitting since we have been playing in New York City essentially today, and Spider-Man of course is taking place in the same city. Yeah, before I go, I want to give a couple shoutouts. I want to give a shoutout to Mola, who's been playing some 7 Days to Die most recently. He's actually currently taking a break from streaming, but I would still recommend leaving a follow in case he's streaming again at some point, because he's an awesome dude. Also want to give a shout out to Rod, who is actively streaming currently. He's also a massive fan of Rockstar games like GTA, of course. He's been actually quite recently doing his GTA 5 10th anniversary playthrough. He's also been playing through Red Dead Redemption 2. And he's also going to be focusing a lot on Assassin's Creed with 5 days a week, starting on Wednesday tomorrow. So yeah, if you're a fan of Assassin's Creed games like I am, you can catch him play for Liberation and Black Flag and the rest of the series as well. So definitely check out that as well if you haven't before. And no very smaller. You take care, dude. I hope you have a good rest of your day. And no worries, Ivarot. More than happy to give you a shout out. Looking forward to the AC marathon. But yeah, for now, let's go ahead and say hi to Ronnie. See how he's enjoying some Spider-Man today. If you want to follow along with the raid, Rod posted some raid emotes earlier in chatware, so feel free to copy and paste them. And yeah, I'll be back tomorrow with some AC3 remastered. I'm gonna continue with sequence 8 and 9, and yeah, focus a bit more on New York. Ironically, it's definitely quite New York themed right now. But yeah, gonna be a good time, so hopefully see you there. Until then, I hope you have a good rest of the day. And I will see you all very soon in the next one. Also, hey, for the Gamer Loop, thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. I actually saw you over there in chat at Ronnie's as well. So that's funny that you joined me here for this end of the stream as well. But yeah, I reckon I'm gonna catch you over at Ronnie's too. Catch you guys next time. Take care.